What's going on, guys? So today I thought I would do a little bit more of an informal video. I don't really have a script of any sorts, but I thought it would be kind of fun to do. So this is going to kind of be a behind the scenes on how I make the triggered videos. Now, I decided to do this because, well, this is a series that's still relatively new to my channel. I only started making these videos about 4 to 5 months ago, but people seem to really enjoy them. So I thought, you know what, why not? Let's kind of talk about the entire process of how to make these. I love teaching people how to do stuff, so I'm pretty excited to kind of talk about this a little bit. So, in terms of making the triggered videos, there's a lot that actually goes behind the scenes. I mean, they look like very simple videos where it's only, you know, they're only 3 to 5 minutes long, but there's actually a lot of steps, there's a lot of different things I have to do. And just to start things off, the first thing is, of course, is to pick the game. Now, picking the game, I kind of have to think about how I want to do it, because it's not just, it can't be spontaneous, okay? Because if I were to pick a spontaneous game, that might not always be the best choice, because as an example, people really like the Mario Kart trigger videos. I've already put out 3 of those. I have, as of right now, I have Mario Kart 64, 8, and Deluxe. So if I were to say, okay, I'm just going to put out a bunch of Mario Kart trigger videos all at once, that wouldn't be a smart idea, because I would rather space those out a little bit so that way people won't get burned out. So like if I were to put out like the rest of the Mario Kart videos, I think there's still like 7 or 6 trigger videos, because I'm going to do a trigger video on every single Mario Kart. If I were to put all those out at once, people would get burned out and they would get tired of it. So I feel it's best to kind of space it out a little bit. So I'm probably going to be doing Mario Kart videos like once a month now. So I'll have one more in May, one more in June, and so on and so forth. And I'm doing the same thing for basically every franchise. I'm doing that for Smash Bros. Smash Bros, I'm spacing out those videos about every month or two. So really, I have to think very carefully about what game I want to put out at what time, because the timing is extremely important. Now, the video that just recently came out, the most recent triggered video, was Super Mario Bros. And that is actually what this is going to be all about. So I've decided, you know what, I haven't done a single 2D Mario game. Let's start with Super Mario Bros. After I decide what the game is going to be, well, the next thing to do is to write the script. And usually writing the script is the longest part. Now, there is a few steps to this. Now, obviously, as you can see on the screen right here, we have a little warning message. This is something that I write every single time. I try to write something witty, Anyway, so it says the following video is over-exaggerated. The game hasn't aged well, but it's still a classic. The following opinions may or may not be accurate to my actual thoughts. I'm probably going to touch on that a little bit more. You may or may not see this in this behind-the-scenes video, but anyways, I generally touch on that warning message 2 or 3 times before I'm finally happy with it. So after that, everything is just based off of a list. So when I'm thinking of what to add to the script, of course, you have to be as cynical and negative as possible. That's kind of the idea. That's the satirical nature of these videos. You want to try to be, you want to think of, like, in terms of how I construct these videos, I try to first think of valid points, and then after that, once I think of valid things that are bad about a game, I'll also think about the most nitpicky and most ridiculous things to complain about, and that's usually where a lot of the humor comes from in the video. Now, usually when I start writing these scripts, I'll just think of something off of the top of my head. So right now, I don't have anything written down. I guess, just off the top of my head, what I can think of right now, this game has not aged well. Let's be real. Okay, so there we go. We have 1 point down. Now, of course, since this is a little bit different, I'm actually talking to a camera. It's a bit harder for me to think of a script while trying to explain how to write the script. Another thing that I do is I actually talk directly to you guys through Twitter, which is why I highly recommend you follow me on Twitter. Because every time I'm about to post, or not about to post, but when I'm starting a brand new trigger video, I always ask you guys what triggers you about a specific game. So I'm actually going to do that right now. I'm going to go ahead and hop into Twitter, and I'm going to tweet this out right now. Now, this is not me being lazy, okay? I know some people might think that after you see this. Basically, I ask you, because I want to make sure I'm not missing anything vital or anything huge. Because I feel like if I didn't ask more people, then I would forget a big valid point. And sometimes I still forget really valid points in my trigger videos, and I feel bad about that. But, you know, you can't be perfect every time. But anyway, let's go ahead and tweet this out. So I'm going to say, hey, guys. So, what triggers you about Super Mario Bros? let me know down below. Okay, there we go. Got that tweet rolling out. Well, we don't have it rolling out, but we do right now. Boom, we good to go. So now all I have to do is just wait a few minutes, and I usually get a bunch of tweets about this. I guess we'll just go ahead and go to my notifications, because we'll probably start getting them rather soon. So anyway, that's kind of how the script works out. I'm not gonna record myself writing this entire script, but this is generally how it works. So this can take me quite a while if you're wondering how long this takes. Generally, writing the script can take anywhere from like 4 to 5 hours for a short game, or even up to 20 hours sometimes for the really long game, for really long games. Just as an example, for Super Smash Bros. For Wii U, I actually had 79 points. I originally had like 83, but I got rid of a couple of them, and I also deleted some of them as I was editing. So depending on how big the game is, it can take freaking forever to write these scripts. Like, the Smash Bros. For Wii U script took an extremely long time to write, just because there was so much to that game. And that's another thing. I actually play these games fully, for the most part. Like, I don't 100% the game necessarily, but I'll definitely explore every aspect of the game. So for Super Mario Bros., I'm going to be playing every single level at least once, if not more, and I'll of course explore any shortcuts or glitches that I could potentially talk about in the video. So after the script is written, well, there's one of two things that I can do next. The order does not matter. One of the first things that I can do is record my audio, or I can capture the footage. So for now, I'm going to show you how I record footage. Now, as you can see, I have an Elgato HD60S on the screen right now. A lot of people ask me what I use to capture footage with. This is what I use for some of my content. So if I'm recording like a Wii U or a Nintendo Switch game, I'll use this HD60S. Now, I'm not going to talk about how to use it because that's not really the point of this tutorial, but that is one of the methods that I use to record footage. Now, I also use emulators and ROMs. Now, there's a lot of debate on whether you should be allowed to use emulators or ROMs. I personally think they're okay, and I generally do that because, first off, I don't have any other capture card to record footage from, say, like an NES or an N64 or even a GameCube. I use emulator and ROMs because, you know, it looks better, because the emulators make the game look better. And I know it's not necessarily the most, you know, genuine thing to do, but I'd like to have as high quality footage as possible, so if I can use an emulator, then I'm going to use one. Now, since I hate keyboards, whenever I'm playing an emulator, I'm almost always using this Xbox 360 wired controller. I think it's a third-party controller of some sort, but I don't care. It works wonderfully. I use it for basically everything. So, of course, I'm going to end up hooking this up to my emulator, and then that's basically what I do. All right, and there we go. And now, as you can see, it's on the screen right now. Now, I'm not sure if I have my controller mapped. I guess let's find out. It doesn't seem like I do. This part of the process can also take a long time. You know, the script generally takes the longest, but also playing the game can take a while. But thankfully, Super Mario Bros. Is a very short game. There's not too much for me to analyze. So, again, now, when recording footage, it's not like leisurely playing. Like, I'm actively critically thinking about the game itself. I'm trying to think of about the graphics, how it feels, the music, the levels. Just, I'm thinking about everything I possibly can that I can critique and nitpick, because, again, that is the point of the show. And that's basically it for capturing footage. I use either an emulator or I use that capture card that I showed earlier. I forgot to mention that I also use OBS to record any emulator footage. So, as you can see, I'm actually using this emulator on my second screen. I'm dragging it from here to there, just so you can see that I use OBS to record all of my emulator footage, in case you were wondering. OBS is okay to use. There are other ways to capture your screen, but overall, if you have a very strong processor and a strong computer, I highly recommend using OBS, because you can adjust a lot of things to make your footage look really, really good. Okay, so now that we have all of our footage, I actually didn't record the footage yet. But anyway, that's besides the point. So let's say we already had all the footage. The next thing we're gonna do is, of course, record the audio. Now, what do I use to record the audio? I use Audacity because it's free and it's nice. Now, I know there are better audio programs that I could be using, but I just use Audacity. I really like it personally. So as you can see, here we have it. I'm using it right now to actually record this video. This is very meta and very confusing. But anyway, I use Audacity. If you want to know what microphone I use, I'm using a Yeti Pro. It's a Yeti Blue Pro, technically speaking. Unfortunately, I can't use the XLR connection. I only have USB. I don't have like a soundboard or anything like that, but that's fine. The quality is, it's pretty good for the most part. I would like to eventually upgrade to either a higher quality microphone or start using the XLR connection for better audio. But anyway, that's besides the point. So generally, when I'm recording this audio, what I'll do is I'll say the line at least twice, if not more. Also, to start off the warning, I do, it is my actual voice. I'm not like changing the tone or anything. So as an example, warning. The following video is over-exaggerated. So I make it a bit deep on purpose, just to kind of set the tone, like, okay, well, this video is about to get serious, and then it's really not that serious. I'll generally say each line twice in a different tone of voice, because I'm not always sure exactly how I want to portray the way that I'm saying a specific point. So for this first one, we have, this game is overrated, let's be real. This game is overrated, let's be real. So, as you can see, I said both of those lines differently, and again, I do that so that I have more options to work with, and that's basically how I record audio. I do also tweak a few things, like I'll remove any background noise, I'll do a little bit of compressing, a little bit of equalizing. I'm not going to get too iffy on the details, but I do those things as well to help kind of clean up the audio a bit more. And now from this point, you'll no longer see my face because the rest of this will just be focused on editing and making the thumbnail. Okay guys, and now we are moving on to the editing section of this behind the scenes video. It's actually been a couple days since I've worked on this behind the scenes. This happens a lot. I don't think I've ever made an entire one of these videos all in one day. I usually have to space it out a few days. But anyway, so now we're in the video editing process. So the first thing we have to do is import all of our footage. And now this is not going to be a Premiere Pro tutorial. I am going to show you like how it's all done, but I'm not going to like try to teach you how to use this program because there's way too much to talk about. Now, to start things off, my organization is terrible with this series. Some of my series I have very well organized, like for the prediction series, I have files that hold my images, video footage, text, music. I still have not gone out of my way to do that for the Triggered series. I just put it in a file called Random Videos. So yeah, I have files for like everything, sound effects, end cards, so like I have the Patreons that scroll at the end, I have the intro, I have all the NB avatars, as you can see right here, you know, disappointed, happy, you know, so on and so forth. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and import all of these. So as you can see, I've got all the footage, and what I'm going to do is just import all of it. And I'm also going to, this is very meta right now, this is footage that you're going to see earlier slash later on. Anyway, so we have all of our video clips as well as all of our audio. Go ahead and open that up, and it's going to take a little bit of time to import. Now, I guess just to kind of start things off, you may notice that everything is numbered. Now, I do this because this actually correlates exactly with my script. This is extremely helpful for me. Some people, whenever they're creating videos with gaming footage in it, they'll just record like a long string of footage for like an hour, and then they'll scrub through it and find the parts. Find the parts they want to use for the video and, you know, whatever. I don't like to do that. I think that's really boring and takes too long. I do that for some videos, but not for this particular series. So, as an example, my first point that I'm going to be making is clip one, so that way I don't have to scrub through a bunch of footage. It does make it more annoying to actually record all this footage because I have to constantly start and stop, but this is just the way that I do it. I don't know if it's convenient or not. But anyway, as you can see, here's my timeline. I kind of already have a basic layout set up. Of course, we have the intro. And of course, the warning screen. So yeah, it's just like a text layer. I just kind of change the words compared to whatever I'm saying. A lot of people have asked me, what is this? What is that sound effect? It actually comes from Super Smash Bros. Melee. It's the warning siren from the adventure mode. I believe you hear this warning siren when you're about to enter the Metroid level when you're trying to escape. I believe that is exactly where it's from Melee, but that is what I use for anyone that was curious. So let's go ahead and throw in the audio. Okay, so I'm gonna probably have some blubber that I don't want to use. Okay. So yeah, I was just kind of testing the microphone. Every time I kind of have to adjust the gain and, you know, adjust how loud and or how quiet my microphone is, I want it to be really good.
So. Warning!
Let's
see.
The
following video.
Warning!
There we go.
The following video. So, okay, so now we have that. We'll go ahead and cut that right into here. So, this makes editing a little bit easier since I already have this set up. So, excuse me. So now I'm just going to kind of listen through and let's just see how this goes.
Warning! The following video.
Okay, so there's already a problem. The audio actually takes a lot longer than most people might think. So my problem with this is that there is way too much of a pause between me saying warning and the following video. So just take a listen.
Warning! The following video.
Dude, that takes way too long. So we're going to go ahead and shorten that up a little bit. So let's try that. We'll see if that sounds better.
Warning! The following video is over-exaggerated. This game hasn't aged well, but it's still a classic. The following opinions may-
Okay, so that is also too long. We'll go ahead and chop a little bit of that out. See how that is. This is kind of a longer warning, actually. Usually the warning messages are pretty short, but this one, I didn't really mean to make it that long. It just kind of happened.
But it's still a classic. The following opinions may or may not be accurate to my actual thoughts.
Right. Okay, so we have that. We'll go ahead and cut there for now. Go ahead and extend the audio. This audio goes for quite a while. I don't know exactly how long this lasts, but, you know, even if I had, like, a minute of a warning message, it would probably last the whole time. Okay, so... So now, that is the first step. We have the audio put together. Now, obviously, we need to change the text. That is pretty easy. All I basically have to do is I'm going to listen to a sentence or two.
The following video is over-exaggerated.
Okay, so that's good. The following video is over-exaggerated. I don't have to change that.
This game hasn't aged well, but it's still a classic.
Okay, so this game hasn't aged well. It's still a classic. So we'll go ahead and hop in here. And we'll change that. This game hasn't aged well, but it's... still class. Whoa, what's going on over there? Okay, so that's good. Again, I don't want text to, well, I haven't said this yet, but I don't want text to go over the frame too much, because I actually have a little bit of a zoom effect. If you look closely, or if you zoom the footage up, I do zoom in very, very subtly. As we can see, whoops, if we go into the effect controls, These are the keyframes for zooming. So actually what I want to do is I want to go ahead. This is the last keyframe that I used for the last trigger video. So I want it to zoom for the entire sequence. So basically I'm going to go ahead and go to the last frame you can see. And we'll just drag that keyframe over there. And now I don't have to readjust that subtle zoom. So we are good to go with that. Okay, fantastic. So the easiest part of the video is done. That is obviously the easiest thing to edit out of everything. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go through all of the audio. Now, you're not going to see all of it. But I'm gonna, again, the audio, in terms of editing the audio, it's very similar to how I just edited that. So actually, I did just record this audio. And I have to say, I was very happy with my first few takes. So I actually don't have multiple takes to work with here, which is not that big. Sometimes I'll record something once and I'll be like, yep, this is it. This is the take I want.
This game is overrated and hasn't aged well.
So I'm pretty sure I was pretty happy with that take.
When you're 5 years...
Yep, I was, because it's not the same thing as this.
This game is...
This game...
When you're 5...
When you're 5... Okay, so go ahead and chop that out.
And it hasn't aged well.
When you're 5... Okay, so if you listen carefully, it doesn't sound right.
Hasn't aged well.
When you're... My next point starts way too early, so I need to zoom back just a few frames, maybe 3 or 4. Go ahead and fill that in.
And hasn't aged well.
When you're 5 years... Okay, so that is probably pretty good. Now, adjusting this little bit of length is probably the most boring part of editing this audio, because I don't want anything to feel too slow or too fast. I want the pace to feel consistent and really nice. And sometimes I'll add extra length to things to add comedy or to add dramatic effect, and we're gonna kind of just go through this and maybe I'll be able to demonstrate some of that.
First Goomba.
This feels too long. Listen to this.
Run into the first Goomba.
As you can see, there is like way too much of a pause, so we're gonna go ahead and chop out probably 2 frames. And that's the cool thing about editing. It's really unbelievable how changing just 1 or 2 frames within a second can really change the way something sounds. So listen to it now.
You run into the first Goomba.
It sounds much better. Heck, I might even chop out 1 extra frame.
and it'll probably make it sound even better. And you run into the first Goomba.
There we go. So it really just, if you really pay attention to how you're saying things when you're editing, it makes a huge, huge difference. Okay guys, so we just finished this video and it looks like it is just barely making 3 minutes. This is one of the, it's one of the shorter trigger videos for sure. And I did kind of make this one purposely a bit shorter because, you know, I was already planning to make a behind the scenes slash tutorial thing on it. So what we're gonna do now is we're going to add all of the footage. Now, you might be thinking, when I add in this footage, well, so as you can see, you know, obviously I use the emulator. So first thing we gotta do is we gotta listen to what the first point is. The first point is,
this game is overrated and hasn't aged well.
Okay, so I don't really need anything specific from this 5 seconds. All I really need is just this little beginning section right here. I guess, you know what, whatever, we'll go ahead and grab that. A little bit of animation, looks kind of cool. So we'll get that, and we'll make sure it's the same length as this audio clip. So as you can see, this is what our final project looks like. Does not look good. We don't want that background. So we're obviously going to have to apply some crop and get rid of that. So we'll throw in the crop. And this can sometimes take a little bit of time. This is a lot easier to do when the screen is really big. I'm actually going to throw this on my second screen just for a moment, just to make sure the crop is really accurate. I will bring it back to the this screen so you can see it again pretty in just a second. All right, so we have the crop pretty much applied at this point. I don't know why this is so... Okay, so there we go. Now it's a lot easier to see this. So at this point, basically, we just want to make sure that it is pretty much centered with the middle. Go ahead and make it a little bit bigger. And we'll just make sure that it's pretty centered. It looks like it's a little more to the left than it should be. Okay, so this right here is looking pretty good. Now, obviously, the background will not be black. We will add a background later. So the first clip is done. This one was pretty easy. So there we go.
This game is overrated and hasn't aged well.
That is it. So now we just move on to the next clip. And this is why I number everything. So instead of having to scrub through footage, I just click 2 because I know that is the next thing that I need. And whoop, it automatically saved. Sometimes it does that. Let's go.
Well, when you're 5 years old, don't know what you're doing, and you run into the first Goomba.
Okay, so when I'm 5 years old, don't know what I'm doing, and I run into the first Goomba. So what I definitely want to make sure I'm doing here is, let me just make this a little bit bigger so it's easier for you guys to see. So I want to look for the part where I am getting hit by the Goomba. So I have to make sure this is in here. I have to make sure that I show that. That is extremely important. So I'm probably going to go back a little bit because I have to keep in mind, I want to be talking. I am talking before I actually bring up the Goomba because I kind of want to try to sync it with what I'm saying. So let's just use that for the time being and we'll see how well that syncs.
When you're 5 years old, don't know what you're doing, and you run into the first Goomba.
Okay, actually, I'm pretty happy with that. There's no adjusting I really need to do there. Now, as you can tell, oh no, I have to crop again. Well, with Premiere Pro, thankfully there's a very easy way to fix this. You can actually grab your attributes, and if you don't know what an attribute is, it's like your settings for a specific layer. So what we're going to do is we're going to copy, and then we're going to paste attributes, and boom! It automatically scales, readjusts, and crops out everything. I don't have to do any of that cropping ever again. One of my favorite reasons to use Premiere Pro, because I don't know any other program that has that. I'm sure other programs do have that, but I love being able to do that. So I don't have to worry about readjusting settings at all. At this point, all I have to worry about is just getting the footage in the correct places, and that's basically it. All right, so basically all I really need to do is just kind of defeat Bowser. We'll grab that. We're gonna be using, okay, so we'll probably be using a good chunk of this, probably not all of this. Okay, and I'm thinking is we're gonna have to cut a little bit through here, maybe more. Let's cut out these two sections and add this. Okay, we'll just see how this synchronizes. It's probably not going to sync properly the first time, but that's okay.
First Goomba. So let's beat Bowser, but instead of a princess, there's this...
Okay, there's this. So I'm about to say Mushroom Guy, so I want to make sure I see the Mushroom Guy. Okay. And I want to make sure the message pops up saying another castle, so let's see if that's synced.
Princess, there's this Mushroom Guy saying she's in another castle. Are you...
Okay, perfect. So, what I want to do, so this is good so far. So actually, let's go ahead and just paste the attributes for both of those layers, so we're good to go there. So now what I want to do, to make this look a little bit more interesting, is when I say,
are you freaking kidding me?
What I'm going to do, I'm going to do a little quick zoom in on Toad.
just for the heck of it. Now, there's no right way to zoom in, but I'm going to do a very fast zoom. It'll probably only be like 5 or 6 frames. So let's go ahead and scale, position, and rotate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we're going to, we're going to go ahead and zoom in. We'll add a little bit of a rotation. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit more. Since we did use, as you can see, this is why I use an emulator, guys, because this is very, very high quality. Okay, so now it looks like we're going to have that zoom. Are you freaking kidding me? Okay, so that makes it a little bit more interesting than the footage itself just kind of staying static in one place. We'll go ahead and just watch through some of that again. Mushroom guy is saying she's in another castle.
Okay.
Are you freaking kidding me?
Okay, so that's good. There probably could be a little bit more that I could do. And I'm going to watch through it again at the very end, see if there's anything else I want to add. But for the time being, I'm pretty happy with just that little effect because it adds enough of a pop to make it more interesting to watch.
All right, and we have finally added all of this video. I actually took another day off. Well, I didn't take a day off, but I didn't finish it. All yesterday because I was working on this yesterday and now it's today, but that doesn't matter. So anyway, we have all the video portions finished. This is actually a pretty simple video to put together. Sometimes there's like a lot of special things I need to add. There's still one piece of footage that I need to get, but I will throw that in there around the end. So now what we're gonna do is create the background, and we'll also work on the intro. So as you can see right now, the background is nothing but black. That's boring, we don't want that. So generally what I'll do is I'll go to Google and see if there's any interesting background that I can use. If there's not anything, I'll make it myself. So we'll go ahead and just hop into Google and let's see, we'll just do a Super Mario Bros. Background. Also just a good way to kind of get some inspiration just to see how things look. Honestly, I don't think I'd like that because I don't think that would blend very well. I kind of want like a different type of color, if that makes sense. Like I'd want something, this is actually pretty fantastic. Except I don't want all these different, like I want to actually have some sort of yellow background like this, but I definitely do not want these types of icons because these are more about the new games. So perhaps when I'm covering like the new Super Mario Bros. Titles for triggered videos, maybe I can use this. But I do really like this. I think I'm going to go ahead and pop open Photoshop and we're going to make something like this, except we'll make our own icons. Now, the way that I usually make my backgrounds, it's not always the most unorthodox way possible. I try to make things look sleek and clean, and it doesn't always work. I mean, I think I have pulled it off a couple of times, but, you know, we're just going to kind of just wing it. That's just kind of how it always goes. Like, I usually just have a general idea of how I want it to work. So for this one, I think what we'll do is we'll have maybe some coins or something like that to work with. So anyway, let's go ahead and do new, and this is taking 5,000 years to load. I don't know why, but that's okay. So there we go. Go ahead and pop that open and I'm going to create that sucker. We made that. We made that background. We just made that. Okay. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and we'll change the background right now. I guess I'll do a paint bucket tool. I'll grab some good old white and bam, that is way too white, or not white. I don't know why I called that white, but let's make it a bit darker. Maybe a little bit darker. That seems, I don't know. I'm not really digging that yellow. This looks kind of pukey. Maybe more like, yeah, right about there. Ooh, I like that. Ooh, I like that. Okay, we're going with that. All right, so I've gone a little bit into this, and honestly, this is way too distracting. There is way too much going on. So I think what I'm just going to do instead is I'm just going to go even more basic, and we're just going to go, I think, just a straight up yellow background. We are going to kind of, let's go ahead and add a little bit of a gradient to it. So what we'll do instead is we'll make a little, it's still going to be yellow, but make it a little bit more interesting to look at. So maybe that's a little too dark. Oh, actually, you know what? That's not that. Whoa. I don't know what I just did, but I kind of liked what was going on right there. That was actually not terrible. I think I honestly might stick with that. We're gonna definitely stick with that. So let's go ahead, and the scale is as big as it's gonna get, apparently. I don't know if I like, there we go. Okay, guys, I'm actually pretty happy with this. It's not the most complicated thing ever, but you know what? This is what we're gonna go with the background. I think this will definitely work. Go ahead and save as. We'll just call it the whatever the heck we're, can you please work with me? Okay. Super Mario Bros. Background. There we go. Well, I didn't spell background right, but that's okay. It doesn't matter. It does not matter. So we'll get out of here. We don't really need to save that because I'm never going to edit that ever again in my entire life. So that is not where I want to save that. Because I'm trying to add the background. We want to put the background in the correct folder. Because if we do that, then everything is just easier and happier. And it's all fun. Background. Because that's how I spelled it. So, we got our background. And flop it on there. And we'll just... we're just going to go ahead and extend this all the way to the end. Awesome. Now, one thing that I am going to have to change is generally my Patreons. I actually haven't added that yet. The patrons are usually in yellow text. That's probably not going to look right. Yeah, this is not good. So we're going to have to change the color, which is not really a big deal. So we'll just change the color to, let's go ahead and highlight the text. We'll just change the color to like a nice light blue, and that should work out pretty well. Yeah, there we go. That's fantastic. We can definitely work with that. Okay, also, speaking of patrons, so the way that this works is basically with Patreon, I'm not going to show this. Because I don't think everyone wants that to be broadcasted necessarily. I mean, obviously people want to see the names, but I don't want people to, I don't know, I don't feel comfortable showing the exact dollar amounts everyone gives me. So what I basically have to do is there's a list that I can go to and I can see all the current patrons. I'm actually editing this, what I'm trying to say is I'm editing this, like, right after payments go through on Patreon, so I can see everyone that paid this month and everyone who didn't. So for the most part, basically I just have to go through this whole list and figure out who paid and who didn't, and if anyone didn't pay, then that's when I remove them from the list. And I know there are a few people where their transactions didn't get through, so I will have to remove them. So I guess I will just do that real quick. All right, so I think we are pretty much done. I only removed, I think, only 3 or 4 names, and that was pretty much it. So now that that's finished, so basically we are pretty much good. There's a couple things I still have to do here. So consider becoming a patron for just $1 a month. And look at that, nice and laggy. That's just how we like it. We love the lag.
Patron for just $1 a month.
Okay, so this is coming in too quickly. So basically I always want the Patreon names to come in after I go on with the whole spiel, whether I'm promoting a video or promoting Patreon. So let's see. $1 a month. Leave a like and subscribe. All right, so this is coming in way too late. So we want to make sure that the Patreons come in like right after I'm done saying that. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit. I need to do that.
$1 a month.
And it looks like we just need a little bit more adjusting. Let's go ahead and scoot this forward a little bit.
$1 a month. Leave a
there we go. That's good. I like that. Okay. So we're definitely good to work with this. So obviously the most important thing is to make sure everyone gets in. I do want there to be like a couple seconds of just kind of silence. I do have to make sure that these are no longer than 20 seconds too. So from this point on at 3 minutes, excuse me, the longest I can go is 3 minutes, 20 seconds. Cause that's when I end the end cards, but I'm probably not going to do that. I'll just make this, 3:13. So this is where I'll end things. I'll just go ahead and mark, or put a little marker so that I know exactly where the video is supposed to end. So at this point, actually real quick, let's go ahead and add a crop. And I'm doing this because as you can see, the names are going all the way to the top and we don't want that. So basically all we have to do is I'm just gonna add a little bit of a crop and cut out half of that. So that way I can put in the end card stuff without the names really being intrusive. There we go, now they kind of just cuts off there. So now we just wanna make sure that this ends basically at the very end. We'll cut this out for now. Now at this point, it's just tweaking the timing. So I'll have to it's really confusing to try to explain how this works, but basically the longer this clip is, the longer the credits last. So now I just have to try to time exactly when I want it to end. So like a little bit longer. Okay, that's good. So there'll be like just a tiny bit of time after the names end, and that's when I'm going to end the video. So basically, Patreon is done. I don't have to worry about the ending at all now. So at this point, we just need to worry about music, the intro, and adding the transitions. And after that, we are basically done. Even though, I mean, it's been like 1,000 steps. This has been probably been a really long video. But yeah, so now we just need to worry about the music. That's going to be the next thing we do. Now, with music, the thing is, I generally try to go for remixes and I try to promote smaller channels. I always put, whenever I'm using someone else's music from YouTube, I always put their song into the description. So honestly, you guys,
if you have the chance, you should always check out the music that I provide in the description, because these guys, they work really, really hard. I know a lot of them do. Let's go ahead and just look up Super Mario Bros., even though you can't see it. I'll go ahead and drag it on in just a second. Okay, Super Mario Bros. Remix. Okay, so we found a pretty sweet little remix going on here. Now, we're not going to use the very first second of this remix. We're going to start it... Let's wait a second. We're going to start it right about there. So, okay, we'll go ahead and grab that. This is 6 minutes, so it's more than long enough. It's way more than long enough. Let's just make sure... Okay. Go ahead and flop that sucker right on there. It's looking good. All right, we'll go ahead and cut it. Right there. Now, sometimes whenever I'm working, like if I want to play like a specific sound from a video, sometimes I'll, you know, I'll cut up the song so that I have to extend it so you can hear that part of the video play. But for this particular Triggered series, I really don't have too much to do with the audio, except just make sure that it ends on time and that the volume is good as well. So of course, for the end, we're gonna add a little fade. Little exponential fade. It's always nice to have a nice little fade thingy at the end. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. Okay, so now the song will fade out. It's gonna be way too loud right now, but just as an example. Have a great day. So yeah, it's way too loud. I also need to extend the background. There we go. Fantastic. Okay, so excuse my squeaky chair. Now what we need to do is we just want to make sure that, let's see how this is going to work. All right. So this actually needs to start a bit earlier. So I'll have to readjust the end for this piece, which is fine. All right, so let's... So I'm thinking right there, that is where I'm going to stop. So from this point forward, this is basically where the video is going to start. So this is how long the intro is going to be. I don't like to make the intros too long. Sometimes I make them kind of long and I don't realize it, but this one, I really don't want it to be that long. So now that we know the length of the intro, at this point, now we know exactly how long the video is going to be. So go ahead and we'll just go back here just to make sure that's realigned. And the video is going to end up being 3 minutes and exactly, well, 3 minutes and 13 seconds exactly, I suppose. Also, I don't know why I have to add this again, but for some reason, okay. All right, there we go. Fantastic. So we have the patrons realigned, the background's good, the music is good. So now we'll go ahead. I know this is kind of so what we're going to do is we're going to have two different volume levels for each song, so I want this to be kind of loud. So let's see. This is probably a little too loud. I don't want it quite at -9 decibels. So we're going to turn that down just a smidge. Maybe turn it down about that much. All right, I'm feeling that. I'm feeling that's good. This is going to go down a lot. We really do not want background music to be too loud. So we'll just start with -30 and see how that is. I also need to add a fade. Otherwise, it'll sound choppy. So go ahead and throw that sucker in there. Maybe like, I don't know, 15. That should work. This game is overrated and has way too quiet. We need to turn that up. You can barely hear that. It's been aged well. When you're 5 years old, maybe, actually, you know, maybe we'll turn that up a bit more, maybe -22. Old, don't know what you're doing, and you run into the first Goomba. So, okay, I'm feeling that. That feels good. Also, this crop is kind of funky. Need to touch that a little bit. Okay, cool, cool. Also, I'm really actually really liking this background. Yeah, I definitely think this background's going to work pretty well. So now, the intro. This is probably the most creative aspect of this video. I have to think of something relatively interesting to put together. So basically what I do is, I'm going to use markers again. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of time these markers to the beat of the song. Alright. Whoops. Whoa, I don't know what I just did there, but let's try again. To my actual thoughts. Okay, so now I have a bunch of these markers that I can work with, and this is going to help me sync together whatever I want to sync together. So what I want to do is I want to add the Super Mario Bros. Logo, which I believe I have from making the thumbnail, which you will see, it's coming up, guys. I don't want you to see the thumbnail yet because that would be spoiling the surprise. So we have a little bit of that. We have the logo in there. Now what we're gonna do is... Basically, I have to add the words how and the logo. And then we also, of course, have to add the triggered sound effects. So, let's see where we can add that. Boom. Okay, I feel like the triggered sound effect should be right there. Okay. So it's gonna be a really short trigger, but let's see. Dun, dun. Okay, I'm feeling that. I feel like that is gonna be really good. So let's go ahead and we'll go to our sound effects and add... oh wait, it's not there, it's not there. Hold on. I'm getting ahead of myself. Okay, there we go. This is what we want. For whatever reason, this triggered audio is very loud, so I always have to turn it down a little bit. -8 or so. Let's see how that is. That's way too loud still. Maybe that will work. Okay, that's probably still a little too loud. I'm thinking this will be better. That's too quiet. -13. No. I fiddle with audio a lot. I don't want the audio lengths to be bad. So it's always important to fiddle with them a lot. Okay, I like that. That feels good. We're gonna go with that. Fantastic. So now we don't have to worry about that anymore. So at this point, I think what I'm gonna do is we're gonna add the how layer. Now how what is this? It's the word how, that's all it is. It's not that special. So we have the how layer. What we're gonna do is let's go ahead and change the font. I'm pretty sure I have a Super Mario Bros. Font on here somewhere. I don't know exactly what it's called, but I have like 1,000,000 Super Mario fonts. And you know, when I say that, I mean I have like 3 or 4, but I'm not seeing it. Oh, here we go. I probably skipped it. Which one? We could probably just use this one, Super Mario 256. This should probably work. Let's work with this. So. What should the color be? You know, let's make the color... Well, first off, I don't want it to be a gradient. That does not sound like a fun idea. Let's go with just a solid light blue, similar to the Patreon. So, let's go ahead. Actually, let's go ahead and center that. So, let's think about how exactly we're going to do this. This is... I kind of have to think. Alright. So, I have an idea. Perhaps what we can do to start off is this can kind of fly onto the screen. Okay, I have an idea. So what we'll do is, let's just raise this for a second. It'll make sense why I'm doing this. So I'm gonna go ahead and extend this just a little bit, because what we're gonna do is this is gonna fly in as the first note plays. So let's go ahead, let's make it fly in from, not that side, from the left. Okay, so done. So that wants to, we want that to end about there. So now that should fly in. Dun-dun. And then this is going to come in at the next note. We'll go ahead and make that slide in from the other side. Done. Okay, I'll put that. We'll smack that right in the middle. How? So. Dun-dun. And then from here, we'll go ahead and add the logo, because why not? Why is this logo so long? Okay, so this is a little big. We'll shrink it a little bit. So from here, what we'll do is... you know what? Let's just, for the time being, let's just kind of have this... Whoa. Actually, I'm just going to hide this layer so I can see. Because I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to move how up a little bit. So we'll add another keyframe. Put that bad boy right here. And while that's moving up, we'll go ahead and... unlock this. Let's go ahead and we're gonna slide this up, I think, from the bottom. So add another keyframe. Okay, all right, so now we have the entire intro completely finished. It's pretty basic, just have a little bit of movement going on. So now there's only one thing that's really missing, and I'm gonna go ahead and play this video for just a second and see if you can figure out what it is.
It hasn't aged well.
When you're 5 years old, can you tell what the problem was? There's definitely a big problem. The problem is there's no transitions. Basically what happens is, so look, there's one clip. It just goes to the next clip. Nothing happens. There's nothing there. So to make these transitions more fun and exciting, what I always do is I add a little sound effect as well as a little push effect as well. So instead of having to manually keyframe moving these, you know, moving one clip from the right and then bringing another one from the left, we're not doing that. We're going to be using a nice little push effect, which is right here. I'll go ahead and drag that right there. Now, the push effects are always 8 frames long. I don't know why, but that's just how I started doing them, and I love that length. As you can see, more interesting.
Well, when you're...
So, it looks a lot more interesting, but still, there's still one more thing we gotta do, is that's add the sound effect, which is called Air Swing 2. Again, it's probably my most used sound effect of all time.
And aged well.
When you're There we go, and now it sounds nice and slick.
Well,
when you're It's great. So basically, this is my last step. I have to apply these to everything. That includes the beginning of this intro. I have to apply it to even the ending when I'm adding, or when I'm talking with the avatars. All of that stuff. And honestly, that's basically it. That is how I make this entire series. So now we're going to go ahead and move on to making the thumbnails and wrapping things up. Okay guys, now the next thing that I'm going to do is actually make the thumbnail. For the triggered thumbnails, there's a few things that I want to keep in mind whenever I'm making these. First things first, what is the main message you want to take across? What do you want people to see? Because keep in mind, a thumbnail is one of the most important things for a YouTube video. It needs to capture someone's attention. Now, what am I going to do? So generally what I do for this is I'm going to look for the logo for the game itself, and I'll look for the main character. So for this, it's going to be pretty easy because there's really not much to work with Super Mario Bros. Like, what I'm probably going to do is I'm going to go ahead and look up the Super Mario Bros. Logo. We'll see what we can find from here. Okay, we'll go ahead and go to images. Okay, so it looks like this is going to work pretty well. I don't think there's going to be any problems with this. So we'll go ahead and just save that image. Now, I do save all of my images to a specific place, so... You can see here's my thumbnails folder. I have thumbnails for that channel doesn't exist anymore. My Let's Play thumbnails, and of course, just my regular thumbnails, as you can see. Also, I have thumbnails for, or I have folders for like all of my thumbnails ever. I don't delete any of them. So this is a triggered video, so we'll go to triggered. It's also categorized by year because, you know, like if I didn't do that, like for example, top 10s. Okay, I've been making top 10s for a long time. All right, look how many thumbnails I have for just 2016. This is just 2016. This is why I put my thumbnails by year. So, you know, I don't have nearly as many top 10s this year. Okay, so triggered 2017. We'll just write logo, which that should be fine. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to look up 8-bit Mario, because I think that's what we're going to use, because that's kind of the most iconic image. And what's going to help us a lot is we're going to look for a transparent image. And one easy way to do that with Google Images is to go to Tools, go to Color, and Transparent. Basically, this makes making the thumbnail a lot easier because generally, if you don't do that, sometimes there'll be like a white background behind a specific character or behind the image itself. So you'll have to get rid of that yourself. But if you use a transparent image, you don't have to worry about that. So there we go. We got 8-bit Mario. He's jumping. That's exactly what I wanted. Go ahead and save as. We'll just call him Mero. Sometimes I have fun and I name the things really stupid things. Like I think there was one time I just called Mario Yahoo! We'll just call him that. Okay, there we go. Awesome. So now, the background. What do we want to do for the background? So the background is also extremely important. So you want to make sure that your background... You want to make sure that it's not connected with the other layers in your... how do I say this? You want to make sure that the background is not connected with the other things in your thumbnail. So as an example, since this is red and brown, since the logo is also kind of brown, I do not want a background that's going to be red or brown because it's going to make it very hard to differentiate the background as well as the characters itself. So what we're going to do is we're just going to look up World 1-1, and what we'll do... Whoa, Super Mario Bros. Wow, that was interesting. Level. Okay, oh, I know what the problem is. I have transparent still on. Sometimes things get a little goofy if you don't turn that off. So basically what we're going to do is we're just going to grab... it doesn't have to be super high quality for the background, at least the way that I make them. So go ahead and grab that. We're just going to call it BG. Yes. Yeah, I call all of my backgrounds BG, so that's why that was there. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and add the background. So it is saved to the triggered... I know I'm going really fast. The point again, it's not really a tutorial. I'm just kind of showing you the strategies and how I make the thumbnails. Okay, so as you can see, now we have a nice blue background. Let's go ahead and put that underneath the triggered layer. Perfect. So this isn't done. So this blue is very good. It's going to really help Mario as well as the logo pop out, which is exactly what we want to see. So I'm going to go ahead and add some Gaussian blur.
Let's do like 20 pixels. So the Gaussian blur, it basically, obviously, it just blurs the image. I'm gonna go ahead and let's do like 25 pixels. I think that's pretty blurry. There's a little bit of, the background's a bit more interesting than just plain blue, which is good. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with that. Let's go ahead and place the Super Mario Bros. Logo. All right, we're gonna go ahead and shrink that a little bit. And let's just put it like right here. I like to turn my logo a little bit. It just kind of, it feels, I don't know how to explain it. It kind of makes it, it kind of sets the tone for the video. If you have things that are a little off or a little different, because that's kind of the tone. Because obviously, Super Mario Bros. Is a classic game. It's, most of the games that I do for trigger videos are pretty good. You know, aside from like, you know, Sonic R, that game's pretty bad. But anyway, I kind of like to tilt my images just to kind of make him look a little bit different. So here we go. We got Mario. I don't like him facing that way. I want him to face the logo. So we're just going to go ahead and flip him around. Okay, another important thing, faces. Faces are super important. Now, with this NES image, it's kind of hard to show his face. Generally speaking, if you're playing a game like something that's more high quality that has, you know, a face that actually looks like a face, you want to look for something really goofy. So, say if I was doing a trigger video on Super Mario 64, what I would probably want to do is I would look up derp, just as an example. And what I want to try to do is find an image like this. This pops out. Okay, this is a really good thumbnail image. This is something you've probably seen used in thumbnails all the time. Now, I can't really do that for this thumbnail, but that's not that big a deal. So let's see, let's go ahead and grab the logo. Now at this point, I'm kind of just going to be tweaking. Another important thing, you want to zoom out. If you can read this, okay, if I'm able to read this thumbnail really small, when it's really small, of course, that means that you guys will be able to read it, because you guys aren't going to see the thumbnail this big. So it's very, very important to do that. I think I'm going to go ahead and just rotate him a tad bit, just a little bit, not too much. All right, we'll go ahead and put him right there. Now what we're going to do is we're going to add a little bit of a stroke behind him. So you could add stroke, you know, that looks okay, but I'm going to add an outer glow. And it's basically a stroke, except it kind of feathers the edges, which is pretty nice. Let's go ahead, we'll make that a little bit thicker, a little bit larger. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do the same thing for the logo. So that's good. And let's go ahead and zoom out again. See how I like that. It's not too bad. Let's just tweak this a little bit more. Let's go ahead and push him back a little bit so we can see a bit. We can make the logo a little bit bigger. Okay, we'll do a little of that. Okay, maybe we can... actually, you know, I'm actually pretty happy with that. So this thumbnail's done. And I mean, that's basically it. Sometimes the thumbnails take a lot longer to make, but this is a much more basic video, so this really wasn't that complicated. So you just want to make sure when you're making thumbnails, you really want to zoom out before you finish. Make sure that you can see it when it looks really small, because if you have too much crap on your thumbnail, if you can't see everything clearly, that's a problem. At least I think it's a problem. That's how I view thumbnails. If you can't see it clearly, it's not a good thumbnail. So we'll go ahead and save that as. I save them all as PNGs. And make sure to put that in the correct folder. And then we'll just call this Super Mario Bros. And that's basically it. That's how you make the entire thumbnail. There's really not much else to it. It's actually pretty basic. But I honestly really, really love making thumbnails. I think it's a lot of fun. So yeah. And basically, this is it. I know I've already talked about editing. Even though I haven't technically edited yet in real time, but that's basically it. If you have any other questions about how to make these triggered videos or just videos in general, please feel free to leave a comment. If you like this, make sure to like and subscribe, and that's pretty much all I have for today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great day, everyone.